What's going on YouTube? The Apophis here, and welcome back to my channel. Today, I'm bringing you another guest, Patatar, another gameplay commentator here on YouTube. He's joining me to have a quick 10-minute conversation with you guys, and the topic today is fantastic. It should be a good time, so I'm going to turn it over to him and take it away, my man.
Hi, guys. This is Patatar87. I'm a pretty new YouTube gamer. I haven't as yet started doing commentaries, but because my headphones are broken, so I'm going to get around to getting some new ones pretty soon. But anyway, I thought team up with the Adophis and bring up a new topic about cheating on Call of Duty and other games as well. And the point that I wanted to bring up about this game is I've seen, like when I was on the map on, I can't remember what it's called now, Turbine, I think it is. Some guy was getting a score a lot higher than everyone else's, but he was nowhere near where the action was. And when I went and found him, what he was doing, he's got someone from the other team doing a tactical insert, and then he was killing them. And I just thought, you know, what is the point in that? So we're just thinking, it's a pretty good topic to talk about, so I just want to know what the Adophis has got to say about this as well.
So my question to you is, in this game, was the guy that was getting all these free kills, basically, was he calling in like big score streaks?
Yeah, it was. I can't exactly remember, but I think he had the is it the VTOL warship?
Yeah, that's a pretty powerful one.
Yeah, the K-9, and I can't remember what the other one was.
See, that's my problem with it personally. To me, if you're sitting in a corner with one of your friends and that's the only way you can have fun playing the game, fine, feel free to do it to rank up, because your rank doesn't matter to me. If I've been in lobbies with master prestiges and made them look like children, whereas but if you're calling in these massive kill streaks, then it starts to affect me, and that's where I start having an issue with it. Like, to me, that part's cheating, because I work hard for my score streaks.
Yeah,
so that's my beef with that.
That exactly. I mean, I can't understand how you enjoy doing something like that, because you're not earning it at all. You're just taking it away. You're taking away the fun experience of the game.
Yeah, definitely.
Cheat, basically.
Definitely. Like one of the things that makes it fun is like you get a like an adrenaline rush, right? Like when you're doing good and you're like, oh fuck, canines. Like, you start to get an adrenaline rush because you're doing well. I mean, when you're doing it like that, you're missing out on so much of the fun, really, because you don't get the adrenaline. It's like, yep, eventually I'm gonna get my dogs.
Yeah.
I don't see how it's
these type of people that just want to get to the prestige the highest they can, but they've got no skill at all.
Yeah, definitely. I just see, in a way, like, I don't like how, like, I really like the camo unlock system in Black Ops 2. I think they made it hard to get camos again, which I do enjoy, but it promotes shit like that. Like, people want diamonds so bad they're willing to have their friends tech insert so they can get headshot after headshot. And I think it ruins the game, but I haven't personally seen it. Like, I've seen a couple videos on YouTube about it, but I've never ran into it in a game. So I wonder, do you think it's as big of a problem as we're kind of making it out to be, or do you think it's kind of isolated?
Well, I'd like to think that it wasn't so much of a big issue as it has been in previous Call of Duty titles. But the more I've played it recently, I've started seeing more and more people doing it. And I just can't understand or can't see the point in it, really. It just, there's, like you said, there's no entertainment in cheating like this at all.
Yeah. What do you think they're boosting for? Do you think most people are boosting for camos or just to get the big streaks that they're never going to get? Like, what do you think the reason is?
I think it's the streaks that obviously they can't get. So they've just got, you know, like one of the friends to say, we'll wait till you're on the other team and then we'll do this.
Yeah, man, they got to be trading off, right? Because I know for me, when I play COD, like, I kind of care about my stats a little bit. And if I was just letting somebody kill me 50 times in one game, I'm not going to have a 0.0 KD and be okay with it. So, like, I wonder what the trade-off is for the guy that's just sitting there getting killed all game long.
I mean, I agree with what you're saying, and I can understand if this were happening on PlayStation, because you don't have to pay to make an account.
Oh, that's true.
On Xbox, I can't understand someone wanting to pay £40 for a membership of you know, Xbox Live, and then deciding to do that and not be bothered about the stats.
Yeah.
I couldn't do it personally.
I wonder if these guys on Xbox, at least, you make a good point about PlayStation not charging you for accounts, but I wonder if the guys on Xbox are like maybe getting paid with Microsoft points or something to do it, because I'm not going to piss my stats away for nobody. Yeah. You know, they're bad as it is. I need to save them as much as I can. So the other thing we were talking about before we got going on this is possible modding over on the PC, like the game itself being modded. And I think that that takes way more fun out of the game than like simple boosting does. Like simple boosting, you could always just leave that lobby and the chances are you're not going to run into another one the rest of the night. Whereas on PC, I mean, if that shit's modded already, I mean, you're going to be in a modded lobby probably 50% of the time. And I know what really bugs me is like the older CODs were modded for the longest time, even on Xbox. And like you couldn't play COD 4 for up until like a month ago because it was just super modded. People flying through the air, aimbots and all that. And I think that really, really kills the game for me. I don't know about you.
I mean, I personally don't like playing on PC games because of the modding. I mean, I used to play Grand Theft Auto 4 on the PC, and I really enjoyed like the, you know, the free roam and stuff like that.
Yeah.
When that first came out, but up until like a couple of months after the game came out, the PC mods just completely destroyed the whole like free roam side of it, because people were just like, you know, using this flame mods that just burnt you as soon as you like walked anywhere near them. And I went back on it a couple of months ago and it was still exactly the same. But the worst thing is that people on the PC that do this can hook it up to their Xbox and do it through their Xbox as well. So I think it's only a matter of time before stuff like this that's happening on the PC is going to come to the console version of it. And that's what eventually ruins games online.
Yeah, I mean, I guess that's the big issue is that it ruins them online. Like, if you were taking these mods and you were playing in a private match with your friends, no harm, no foul, right? Because that doesn't that doesn't impact the rest of us that want to play the game normally. But it's the public cheating, man. It's just, I don't understand it. And I don't, like, I've been in a lobby in COD 4 that was modded to hell and back. And, like, we were, like, flying around, even in World at War and stuff. And for, like, 10 seconds, I was like, this is kind of entertaining. But after that, it was 100% annoying. Like, I don't understand how that's fun for some people. Like, to me, it just, it's not the way it's meant to be. So it really messes me up mentally.
Yeah, I just can't understand why anybody would want to pay, you know, the £40 or I don't know how much it is in America, $60 a game.
Yeah.
And then do this to practically, you know, 50% of the people who've paid good money to enjoy a game and then no longer can do because people like this just enjoy ruining other people's fun.
Yeah, I think the developers should be more on top of it, you know, and try to cut it, you know, cut it sooner than they do. Like, it seems like it took them a very long time to patch a lot of the Call of Duties when they were broken. And it comes back to the point where we spend a lot of money for these games and then to have people exploiting them and cheating. Like, I understand they can't test for everything. Like, they probably didn't even know, like, some of this stuff was possible by when they released it. But once they found out, I feel like they take their time getting around to fix it. Like, it's totally on their schedule.
Yeah. And I've heard people, like, you know, boasting on websites that when they get banned, that they can just change your IP address and then they can go straight back on. And you just think, you know, it's not resolving the issue at all, even if you do patch it, because these type of people still end up finding a way to get back on and then doing it all the same again.
Yeah, I've seen quite a bit of interesting things in forums when it comes to game modding in general and even console modding. But I really thought this topic was awesome, man. It was a good chat. The gameplay is actually wrapping up, so I wanted to take a couple seconds to just thank you for coming on and doing a dual com with me. I really like to reach out to other people in the community. Plus, to me, these type of commentaries are way more fun than me just sitting there talking. Like, I prefer the conversation type. So thank you so much, man.
I appreciate it. It's been good fun.
That's awesome. And if anybody else out there wants to do something very similar to this, all you have to do is send me an inbox message on YouTube. This guy can attest to it. I got back to him in like an hour or two, and we set this thing up.
Really?
Yeah. I love doing it. So thank you all for stopping by. I hope every single one of you guys has a fantastic day. And my outro is about to start to roll, so make sure you stay tuned and listen to that, because it's always a good time. Thank you, guys. All right, guys, there you have it. Another awesome DualCon brought to you by yours truly, The Apophis. Two videos on the screen, guys. Click them. They open in a new window. The shit ain't going to hurt you, and you're probably going to enjoy them if you enjoyed this one. Big yellow subscribe button. Click that. It would mean the world to me if you decided to stick around because you thought this video was worth it. As always, guys, follow me on Twitter because really that's how you're going to interact with me. And I try to interact with as many of you as I possibly can. So make sure you add me on Twitter and feel free to tweet me. I'm going to answer you. Not a big deal. All right. I really, really appreciate the views. I appreciate the support that I've been getting quite a bit of lately. You guys have been really motivating, and I just can't thank you enough. As always, guys, you kind of know how this one ends. So if you're going to order a pizza, leave off the anchovies.